Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Enter into Anathoth. As for me, in justice I shall behold your face. I shall be filled with vision of your glory. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
And welcome. Brother and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters,
that
I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray, O God, who show the light of your truth to those who go astray, to return to the right path, with all who, for their faith they profess, are common Christians, the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and strive after all that does it honor, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Those living
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
In the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus was going through a field of grain on the Sabbath. His disciples were hungry. He began to pick the heads of grain and eat them. When the Pharisees saw this, they said to him, "See, your disciples are doing what's unlawful to do on the Sabbath." He said to them, "Have you not read what David did when he and his companions were hungry? How he went into the house of God and ate the bread of offering? Neither he nor his companions nor the priests could lawfully eat. Or have you not read in the law that on the Sabbath the priests serving the temple violate the Sabbath and are innocent? I say to you, something greater than the temple is here. If you knew what this meant, I desire mercy, not sacrifice, you do not condemn these innocent men. The Son of Man is the Lord of the Sabbath." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
If you knew what this meant, I desire mercy, not sacrifice, you would have not condemned these innocent men. The Son of Man is the Lord of the Sabbath. If you knew what this meant, I desire mercy, not sacrifice, you have not condemned these innocent men. The Son of Man is the Lord of the Sabbath. You see, we see this struggle. The real struggle, to go back and say, "Well, that was those people back there. Those are the ones that were condemning Jesus. Those are the ones that didn't get him." And we just kind of sit back. We think we're so pious, and we got it, and we understand it, and just live our little life, and kind of come and go, and find Jesus here and there, and life is up and down, and whatever. But do you really know what it means? Do you really know what it means that I desire mercy, not sacrifice? I think every single day of our life, every breath of our life, if that just that one little phrase right there, "I desire mercy, not sacrifice," we could just live that little piece, look how everything would be so much easier. Everything would be filled with so much more grace and love and goodness and happiness and peace and joy. So I think the real question that's really before us yet again today is, why do we make things so hard? Why do we make them way more difficult than they are, in the difficulty that we're already faced with all the difficulties around our life? But again and again and again and again and again and again and again, over and over and over again, Jesus did not come to complex our life. Jesus did not come to give us more drama. Jesus didn't come to add more things to our plate. Jesus didn't give us more guilt, more shame, more embarrassment. Jesus came. Jesus died. Jesus rose for freedom. To be free. And it's so simple, but yet such another reality. And that's how we need our faith, that's how we need our church, that's how we keep coming back. But to keep it simple. Just think as I close today. The battle. The battle. You can say, ah, that's the battle out there. The battle is all these people that are, you know, that's, and we just kind of start to sift through all that. But we don't realize our own battle. Our own struggle. And as real as that is, and even the battle, the struggle to believe, the battle, the struggle to understand, the struggle of life, you name it. But if we always remember, in every battle, in every struggle, the victory. Victory is right at our eyes, right at our eyes. Because of the love and mercy of Jesus Christ. And the love and the mercy that He is calling us. Trusting in God's providence, mercy, and divine love, we now turn our prayers and petition for the very thing of grace. We pray for Holy Father Pope Francis. We pray for Archbishop Lucas. We pray for our entire Catholic Church, 1 billion plus strong. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for an end to all violence. We pray for peace in our world and peace in our streets. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those that are struggling. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our three beautiful parishes, that we will continue to be places of love and mercy. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our farmers. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our military, we pray for our veterans, and we pray for those that died in the line of duty. Their souls are with God. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all your thoughts and all your prayers and all your petitions, you so beautifully hold this beautiful morning and the beautiful silence of your beautiful hearts. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, what a beautiful message you give us yet again today. Help our hearts to permeate this word and truly live it, and help us in our challenges and struggles to overcome them in your grace and love. We make all these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Through the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, through the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Look upon the offering to the church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you. Grant that what we are consumed by those who believe may bring ever greater holiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty God, and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery he accomplished a marvelous deed, by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works. For you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with the angels and archangels, with the thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and George, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him, says the Lord. Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.